Now, these two cases are regarding the scope and application, you can say, or what is the main motive behind introducing this legislation. Okay, so first one is this JK Industries Limited versus Chief Inspector of Factories. Both these two cases were filed before Supreme Court only. In this first one, it was held that Factories Act 1948 is a social welfare legislation which was enacted primarily with the object of protecting workmen employed in factories against industrial and occupational hazards. So this case you can also include when you are writing about that hazardous process, right? That part also, you can include this one. So the main purpose was that if some worker is there who is working in some kind of an industry or is involved in some kind of an occupation which is hazardous to his health or something like that, then this legislation would be providing for certain benefits. So you must have studied that there are all these different provisions relating to health, safety, and all that stuff, right? Working conditions, leave, maternity benefit, all those are mentioned. Why? Just in order to ensure welfare of the workers who are working there. It seeks not only to ensure that workers would not be subjected to long hours of strain, but also that employees should work in safe, healthy, and sanitary condition, and that adequate precautions needs to be taken for their welfare. So whoever is like the managing that particular factory, right? It might be some management committee, some managers, or whoever is the occupier, basically, right? Whoever is having that responsibility, that person needs to ensure that workers are able to work in a better and comfortable position. So that was the main purpose behind this legislation. The stringent provisions relating to obligations of the occupiers or managers with a view to protect workers and to secure to them employment in conditions conducive to their health, safety indicate the broad purpose of the act. So if you look at certain provisions also, it will say that there are some things which cannot be like completely removed, right? If it's a factory, it is going to create some kind of noise, vibration, pollution, all that stuff. But what the managers or what that occupant can do is they can try to reduce it as much as possible. They can try to keep it separate from where the workers are working, right? If there is a machine which is creating a lot of noise or vibration, they can at least set that up in a separate room, right? So those steps need to be taken for the welfare of the workers and in order to ensure that this basic purpose or object of this act is being satisfied by them. The act and rules made thereunder imposes numerous restrictions upon occupiers or managers of the factory just to ensure that workers are given adequate safeguard with regard to their health, physical well-being, and to ensure their safety and healthy condition. There are also provisions wherein it says before employing a certain worker in any hazardous work, you need to do his complete medical checkup while he is in his job, while he is in that work. That time also regular checkups need to be done, right? So all those provisions accordingly are being added. All those guidelines the occupier needs to follow, or manager, whoever is responsible, basically, those persons need to follow that.